الحمد لله الكريم المجيب لكل سائله التائب على من تاب وليس بينه وبين العباد حائل القادر على كل شيء ولا يقدر عليه أحد لا يشغله شأن عن شأن وغيره عن شأنه مشغول لا يسأل عما يفعل وكل من عداه مسؤول وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له في أرضه وسمائه لا شبيه ولا مثيل ولا والد ولا والدة له كان ولا مكان وهو على ما كان قبل خلق المكان علم ما كان وعلم ما يكون وعلم ما لا يكون لو كان كيف كان يكون هو الأول هو الآخر هو الظاهر وهو الباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله القائل فضلت على الأنبياء بست أوتيت جوامع الكلم ونصرت بالرب مسيرة شهر وجعلت لي العرض طهورا ومسجدا وأحلت لي الغنائم وأرسلت إلى الخلق كافة وختم بي النبيون والقائل أتاني جبريل فقال إن ربي وربك يقول أتدري كيف رفعت ذكرك قلت الله أعلم قال جبريل يقول الله لا أذكر إلا ذكرت معي وصدق حسان حيث قال وضم الإله اسم النبي إلى اسمه إذا قال في خمس المؤذن أشهد وشق له من اسمه ليجله فذو العرش محمود وهذا محمد اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الأتقياء البررة وعلى من هدى هذوهم وسلك سبيلهم إلى يوم الدين وبعد إخواني في الله أمرنا ربنا بالصيام فصمنا، ودعانا للقيام فقمنا. ولكن كيف أشعر أن الله تقبل صيامي والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه، ومن قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. كيف أشعر أن الله تقبل صيامي؟ الناس بعد رمضان أيها الإخوة فريقان: الفائزون والخاسرون. من منا هذا الفائز؟ الجواب قوله تعالى في سورة مائدة، قال تعالى: واتل عليهم نبأ ابني آدم بالحق إذ قربا قربانا فتقبل من أحدهما ولم يتقبل من الآخر قال لأقتلنك قال إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. قال العلماء: من صام رمضان وهو يحدث نفسه أنه لا يعود إلى المعصية دخل الجنة، أنه لا يعود إلى المعصية بعد رمضان دخل الجنة. إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. ومن صام وهو يحدث نفسه بالعودة إلى المعاصي بعد رمضان فصيامه عليه مردود والعياذ بالله. إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. إذن كيف أشعر أن الله تقبل صيامي؟ وهل هناك علامات تدل بعد رمضان أن الله تقبل صيامي؟ نعم، هناك علامات. ومن علامات قبول الصيام أيها الإخوة الاستقامة. يقول الله تعالى في سورة فصلت، قال: إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. وقال في سورة الأحقاف: إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا فلا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. جزاك اللهم خير معلم علمت بالقلم القرون الأولى، وأرسلت موسى بالكتاب مبشرا، وابن البطول فناول الإنجيلا، وفجوت ينبوع البيان محمدا، فسقى الحديث وعلم التنزيلا، لا تذكر الكتب السوالف قبله طلع الصباه فأطفئ الكنديلا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه. أيها الأحبة في الله، My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us about something very important. If you are a human being, you are a believer, you are a sinner, now Allah is saying to tell you, نَبِّعْ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. He said to tell you that He forgives. the creator, the one we worship. We have no one beside him. He is the only one we worship. He is the commander. He is the creator. He is the only God that we believe in. He is telling you that whenever you commit sin, a lot of sin, do not be scared. Do not be afraid. Just say, Astaghfirullah. Sincerely, he said he will forgive you. Allahu Akbar. Is there any God like Allah? Is there any deity that deserves to be worshipped beside Allah? A'ilahumma Allah. Upon all this thing that we're doing, he said to tell you, Nabbi ibadi, anni ana al-ghafur rahim. He said to tell you that he forgives. Ya Allah, forgive us our sin. Alhamdulillah. Brothers, I bear witness our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah's last and final messenger. He said, Jibreel came to him and said, Ya Jibreel, Ya Muhammad, Allah is asking you, do you know how high he raised you? Qultu Allahu a'lam. He said, I don't know. Allah knows. I don't know how high he raised me. Jibreel said to the Prophet Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to tell you that whenever his name is mentioned, it will be accompanied by with your name. Whenever you hear Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, you will hear Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Whenever you hear La ilaha illallah, you will hear Muhammadur Rasulullah. This is the love of Allah to his servant Muhammad. Hassan ibn Thabit said, وَضَمَّ الْإِلَهُ اسْمَ النَّبِيِّ إِلَى اسْمِهِ إِذَا قَالَ فِي خَمْسِ الْمُؤَذِّنُ أَشْهَدُ. The five daily prayers. Whenever you hear La ilaha illallah, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, you will hear Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. وَشَقَّ لَهُ مِنْ اسْمِهِ لِيُجِلَّهُ to raise him high. فَذُ الْعَرْشِ مَحْمُودٌ وَهَذَا مُحَمَّدٌ. He is the last and final messenger. If you want peace in your life, if you want comfort in your life, then follow and obey and accept the message of the Comforter, Muhammad. وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. If you obey him, if you follow him, if you accept him, تَهْتَدُوا, you will be guided. May Allah guide us. Brothers, our Lord the Creator, he commands us. He commanded us to fast, and we fast. Alhamdulillah. The Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commanded us to pray, to stand on our feet during the month of Ramadan and pray the whole night of Ramadan. We did. But there is a question here. How do I know Allah accepted my fasting? Brothers, we strived hard. It wasn't easy. We fast 16 hours straight for 29 days. The weather was very hot. But because we always say, Sami'na wa ata'na to Allah, that we hear and we obey, we fast. It doesn't matter what the weather was going on in the weather, we don't care. As long as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to fast, we did. Being so obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should stand on our feet. We started from Alif Lam Mim to Min al Jinnati wal Nas. You stood on your feet. Sometimes you are tired. But it will not stop you from coming the next day. You did. You came. You prayed. You cried behind the imam. When you made sujood, you were crying. The heart moving. And this is the sign of the believers. إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. Yes, when you listen to the recitation of your imams, you were standing behind them, it increases your iman. This is to tell you that you are indeed a believer. So after all this, Alhamdulillah, Ramadan is gone. But how do I know that my fasting is accepted by Allah? How do I know? Because my brothers, when it comes to Ramadan, people after Ramadan are divided into two groups. We have Al-Faizun and Al-Khasirun. We have winners and we have losers. Am I a winner or am I a loser? Are you a winner or you are a loser? Which one is it? Which one is it? And do you know something? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Whoever fast during the month of Ramadan with iman, with faith, wa ihtisaban, and seeking its reward from Allah, his previous sin will be forgiven. Ya Allah. So, how do I know my previous sins are forgiven? And he said, "Man qama Ramadana imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Whoever prays during the month, the night of Ramadan, with faith and seeking its reward from Allah, his sin will be, previous sin will be forgiven. How do I know? Because I did pray. I did pray during the month of Ramadan. I did fast during the month of Ramadan. But how do I know my previous sins are forgiven? This is ghaib. This is something only Allah knows. But there are signs that will lead you to knowing or accepting or understanding that indeed your fasting has been accepted. Now, brothers, let's take a journey in the book of Allah. Surah Al-Ma'idah. Listen to Allah. وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ ابْنَيْ آدَمَ بِالْحَقِّ إِذْ قَرَّبَا قُرْبَانًا فَتُقُبِّلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمَا وَلَمْ يُتَقَبَّلْ مِنَ الْآخَرِ قَالَ لَأَقْتُلَنَّكَ قَالَ إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Headline: إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Relate to them, recite to them, narrate to them the story of the two sons of Adam when both of them offered a sacrifice. And it was accepted from the other, and the other, the second one was rejected. The one whose offering was rejected, he said to his brother, "La'aqtulanna, I will kill you. I will surely kill you." The brother said to him, "Don't you know, innama yataqabbalu Allahu minal muttaqin? Don't you know Allah only accepts from those who guard against evil?" This is the headline. How do I know Allah accepts my fasting? إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts only from those who guard against evil. Brother, our scholars said, مَنْ صَامَ رَمَضَانَ وَهُوَ يُحَدِّثُ نَفْسَهُ أَنَّهُ لَا يَعُودُ إِلَى الْمَعْصِيَةِ بَعْدَ رَمَضَانَ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. التكبير. Listen. Whoever fast Ramadan, before you start fasting during the month of Ramadan, you had an intention, and the intention was, "I am going to fast Ramadan. I am going to be so obedient to Allah, and I want to continue. I'm going to continue. I will never go back to the sin that I was doing before Ramadan." If this is your intention, then our scholars said to tell you, your fasting has been accepted. But من صام رمضان وهو يحدث نفسه بالعودة إلى المعاصي بعد رمضان. The person who fasts during the month of Ramadan, but thinking that, you know what, you know, brothers, let's be honest to each other. Believe me, some of us, Ramadan came as a chain. You know, when the way Allah chained the shaitan,
That's how they feel. They can't wait for this man to go so that they will go back to their. Complete it. So the Ramadan is there. They are fasting because they see the, some of the brothers are fasting. They come to the masjid because the friend, they don't have any friends to talk to. So they will fast. But how many? Today Ramadan is how many days? 15? Oh, wow, I thought it was 20. Because he can't wait for it to go. He wants to go back to what he was doing. If this was your intention, our scholars said to tell you, Subhanallah, you're fasting, only Allah knows. But brothers, let me remind you something. Do you know there is a history of hatred between us and Shaitan? And this hatred, that's why when Ramadan came, Allah chained our enemy to give us lessons that how to fight our enemy, Shaitan. Allah said in Surah Al-A'raf, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ ثُمَّ صَوَّرْنَاكُمْ ثُمَّ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, after I created you, I fashioned you, then I ordered the angels to prostrate to Adam, فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ. They all prostrated to Adam to greet him except Iblis. He said no to Allah. مَا مَنَاكَ أَلَّا تَسْجُدَ إِذْ أَمَرْتُكَ. What is stopping you from prostrating? He said in Surah Al-A'raf, أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْهُ خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ طِينٍ. Oh Allah, I am better than Adam. You created me from fire and him from the mud. How? I will never prostrate to him. قَالَ فَاحْبِطُ مِنْهَا فَمَا يَكُونُ لَكَ أَن تَتَكَبَّرَ فِيهَا فَاخْرُجْ إِنَّكَ مِنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ. Get out of my kingdom. This is what Allah told him. You know what he said to Allah? أَنْظِرْنِي إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. Allah, respite me. Let me stay till the end of the time. Allah said, إِنَّكَ مِنَ الْمُنْظَرِينَ. Take it, you have it. قَالَ فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. He said, oh Allah, this is what you did to me because of Adam. I will make sure I will take some of his children to Jahannam with me. I'm not going alone. I'm not going down alone. I will stand on their way. Brothers, I want you to follow this. I will stand on their way, making sure I take most of them with me. Because of this, Allah in his mercy, he gave us Ramadan. And he chained Shaitan. That's why you see you are able to fast, you are able to read Quran, give sadaqat, pray during the night. Allah trained you so hard to let you know. After Ramadan, he will release your enemy. And now you have taken the lesson, so try to fight. Because Allah told him, إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٌ. There are some group of my servants, of my slaves, that you, Shaitan, have no power over. May Allah make you among them. So, brothers, in the same surah, Allah said, he's calling on you and I, Ya Bani Adam, you heard the story of what happened between your father and Shaitan. لا يفتننكم الشيطان كما أخرج أبويكم من الجنة. Do not let Shaitan deceive you. Do not let Shaitan harm you. Now he is on chain. He is out. But you already took the lesson. You took the classes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trained you. Now fight him back. Say no to him. Say no to him. It's only a week after Ramadan. Let me ask you. How are you doing after Ramadan? Only a week. Only a week. How are you doing after Ramadan? What is going on? Ask yourself. Now you can say, Alhamdulillah, Allah indeed accepted my prayer, my fasting. Oh, no. Ask yourself, how are you doing only a week after Ramadan? How are you doing? Look, brothers. يا أيها الذين أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول. Allah said, oh you who believe, أطيعوا الله, obey Allah. We obeyed Allah, brothers.
كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.
An order that we should fast. And we fast. Order from whom? Allah. We prayed during the night of Ramadan. Because we followed who? We obeyed who? Our Prophet Muhammad. So, أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول. You recite Quran. You give sadaqat. You brother, the TV you were watching, even if you watched it during the Ramadan, you were so careful about the channels you were watching. So now, أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول. After Ramadan,
ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم.
You hear Allah? Brother, this is Quran.
أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم.
Obey Allah, obey His Messenger. Do not spoil your deeds after Ramadan. Do not. What you did in Ramadan was so great. Allah said,
وَلَا تُبْطِلُوا أَعْمَالَكُمْ.
Do not spoil it. It's only a week after Ramadan. Maybe you are not married. Maybe you don't have a wife. Let me ask you a question. Right after Ramadan, when she called you, or when he calls you, what did you tell him or her? Did you tell him what Yusuf said to Zulaikha?
إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَايِ قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَايِ.
That's what you told her, or that's what you told him? When he called you, back to the old business. When she called you, back to the old business. Did you tell her, A'udhu Billah, no way, no more? Did you say that to her? That's what Yusuf said to Zulaikha. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do, brothers.
وَلَا تُبْطِلُوا أَعْمَالَكُمْ.
Do not spoil your deeds after Ramadan. Let's continue. How do I know? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted my fasting. He accepted my prayers. He accepted my sadaqat. My brothers, listen. Is there any sign? Yes.
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ.
Indeed, those who say our Lord is Allah.
ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا.
And they continue on the course, the right course. They stay on the right course.
ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا.
They continue.
تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا.
Now I can congratulate you. If you were doing the same thing you were doing during Ramadan, وَأَبْشِرُوا. Good news to you. Glad tidings to you. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed accepted your fasting. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed accepted your prayers.
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ.
Surah Al-Ahqaf.
ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ.
Do not fear. No grief. Don't worry. Are you disturbed if Allah accepted my fasting? Are you so worried if Allah rejected my fasting? Don't worry. Allah said, if you stay on the right course after Ramadan,
فَلَا خَوْفٌ.
No fear.
فلا خوف عليهم.
No fear for you. No grief. Yes, he accepted your fasting. May Allah accept our fasting. How are you doing with Quran, brothers? In the Ramadan, a week before this, you were so busy in the Quran. How are you doing? How is the Quran doing with you? Did you pack it and put it back to the closet? Or you continue? How many pages are you reading now since Ramadan rose? Or since after, believe, brothers, do you know some of the brothers, we know each other, we know ourselves, believe me. Someone can tell you since Ramadan finished, I never opened the Quran. Why? كونوا ربانيون ولا تكونوا رمضانيون. Are you worshiping Allah only during Ramadan? Or you are worshiping Allah at all times? So brother, how are you doing with Quran? You know the virtues of Quran. When Ramadan came, you were so good in Quran. Brother, continue reading the Quran, because there is no speech better than the book of Allah. Believe me, no speech. Because Al-Quran Kalamullah, it is the speech of Allah. And is there anyone greater than Allah? Then how are you doing with praying with the Jama'ah after Ramadan? Now the masajid are crying. The masjid is crying. It was full during Ramadan. Now we have only a line and a half. Where are you after Ramadan? What's going on?
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا.
And they continue on the right course. Are you on it?
ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ.
So brothers, let's continue. We took a lesson. Let's continue. Let's pray with Jama'ah, read Quran, give sadaqat. Brothers, our time is up. But I was going to also remind my brothers about something very important and my sisters, which is the what you watch.
قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ ذَلِكَ أَزْكَى لَهُمْ.
Say to the believing men,
يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ.
Lower their gaze, وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ, and let them guard their modesty.
وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنَّ وَيَحْفَظْنَ فُرُوجَهُمْ.
My sister, during Ramadan, you cover up. You were like Maryam during Ramadan. Right after Ramadan, you went back. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said for you to cover up. They told you not to cover up because it's so hot. But listen to the Quran.
وَقَالُوا لَا تَنْفِرُوا فِي الْحَرِّ.
They said, sister, it's too hot. It's 90 degrees outside. Why are you dressing like this? It's too hot.
قُلْ نَارُ جَهَنَّمَ أَشَدُّ حَرًّا.
Say to them, hellfire is more hotter.
لَوْ كَانُوا يَفْقَهُونَ.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this easy. May Allah forgive us. Brothers, inshallah, after just a few minutes of your time, inshallah, after the prayer, Allah bless us with a baby, inshallah. Please, a few minutes of your time after prayer, we will pray for the baby and for our children, because they are our future. Without them, we are nothing. We pray, may Allah bless our children. And also, our classes start tomorrow. The children class Saturday, Sunday starts. Our Monday memorization class, we have Monday's memorization class for adults. They are memorizing the Quran, alhamdulillah, and they are working people like you and like you, my brothers and sisters. They are memorizing the Quran, alhamdulillah. Brothers, I am so happy. I am proud to say, bi-idhnillah, they memorize the whole of Baqarah. They have families like you. They have children like you. They are working people like you. But they come every Monday. They sit down. Alhamdulillah, we memorize the entire Surah Al-Baqarah, 286 ayah. We started Ali Imran. And alhamdulillah, we have also children who are memorizing the Quran from 7 years, 8 years. Alhamdulillah, we finish also memorizing Surah Al-Baqarah. We're going to start on Saturday, inshallah, Surah Ali Imran. And also, our sisters program, inshallah, we will start very soon for the sisters. So we have our Monday classes, and we have Juzu Amma for the beginners on Tuesdays between Maghrib and Isha. Monday for the Baqarah group who are memorizing. Tuesdays, inshallah, for the beginners, we start from Amma Yatasa'alun going down. So the masjid is always busy. which inshallah lessons you are welcome. Barakallahu feekum. Allahumma ihdina fi man hadayt wa afina fi man afayt wa tawallana fi man tawallayt wa barik lana fi ma a'tayt wa qina sharra ma qadayt innaka taqdi wa la yuqda alayk. Allahumma ihdina wahd bina waj'alna sababan liman ihtada. Allahumma a'id alayna ramadan. Allahumma a'id alayna ramadan. Allahumma a'id alayna ramadan. Ya hayyu ya qayyum, ya hayyu ya qayyum, ya hayyu ya qayyum. Wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi la ilaha العظيم. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على رسول الله وقوم إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.